Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this afternoon's matchup between the Cincinnati Bengals and the San Francisco 49ers.
Back in your days when you had to take on a team from the AFC, didn't know them all that well. What was it like as we have this little interconference matchup today?
Well, I thought back in those days, Jim, we were about ready to show them what toughness and hard hitting was. Today it's a little different, but I'll tell you this, this NFC team, they are a hard hitting bunch.
They're all over him at the 18-yard line. Setting up in the pistol on this play, the wide receiver in motion. First and 10, LaMichael James gets the carry.
They're going to run it right.
That tackle was made at the 27-yard line, imposing their will early on the defense with a solid effort on the ground.
And we talk so much, don't we, about the passing game in the NFL, but it's still about who can out-hit the other one, and right now the offense, they are winning that battle. Nice run.
The 49ers in the pistol.
Second and a yard.
He'll throw it over the middle. Bolden's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Mavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
LaMichael James is in the backfield. The wide receiver shifting around in motion.
Second and one.
Gets it again here. Left side. Gain of 17.
What a job that time by the offensive line. That hole was so big, you could have drove a car through it. The running back hit it full speed, and that allowed him to get down the field and get that long run.
Set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Going to be a tackle for a loss.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Throws the pass. Terrence Newman with the pick. That brings the play to an end.
Well, that's a rough way to get the game started, isn't it, Phil? Come out and throw an early pick.
Oh, it is. It's a terrible way to start for the quarterback and everybody involved. But I'll tell you this, I think it was a terrible call. So the quarterback, when the play's not there, throw it away. He took a chance, and that's why it was intercepted.
And the defense will use one of its timeouts right here. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
They'll go ground. Gains 5.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets them a few yards.
5-yard gain on the play.
The Bengals will approach this play from out of the pistol. Makes the catch. That last play made by Patrick Willis.
Good job that time by the quarterback. Throw the short pass, even though it doesn't result in a first down. Now on third and short, all of your passes are in play instead of just the third long where you only have like 3 or 4 plays you can go to.
Here's the handoff, running off tackle.
Well, that time, the defense gets the tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Listen, I blame this one on the quarterback. When you see the defense in a situation like that, you must change the play. Don't waste one in the NFL. You don't get enough chances as it is, and that one lost yards.
Dalton's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
Catch is made. Five, maybe six out of them.
What was the defense doing that time on that fourth down try by the offense? Disorganized, not ready, and they give it up.
That reception gave them the first down.
Handoff to the back. He's brought down.
The off-tackle run. It's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Nothing fancy about that, but it's a good run. Gets a first down. Now the offense has three more chances.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Another carry here. Nice tackle.
You cannot let offensive players get up the sideline in the NFL. That's where a lot of big plays are made. The defensive end that time, well, he was on the end, and he stopped that run for very little gain.
Gresham's playing out of position in the backfield here. Dalton's going to take it from the gun.
They bring him down at the 29-yard line.
There's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, the double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
Let's see how they back up the big play here.
Out of the eye, the give to the tailback.
This has been a long drive so far.
Escaping the pressure.
And incomplete.
We see it so often nowadays. All quarterbacks moving around the pocket. That time he gets outside the pocket. But as he looks down the field, nowhere to throw it, nobody open. Just another incomplete pass.
Marching down the field and taking their time.
Third and 10.
Throws to the right. Off the mark here as this throw heads out of bounds. Gresham's a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play. Looking to scramble. And he hauls it in.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
This will probably be the last play of the quarter. First and 10.
Under pressure and incomplete.
Colin Kaepernick under center. Second and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker. That wraps up the first quarter here in San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the second. The 49ers lined up in the pistol. And the second quarter is underway with this snap for a gain of about five.
An off-tackle run, it's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
The quarterback motions the wide receiver. Second and four. They give it to the back, and he's running off tackle.
The ball is out. This one's going back the other way. They pounce on him there.
That's what you call a takeaway. The defense just makes such a hard hit that they take the football away from the offense, and they recover the fumble.
Come to the line, and it's first down. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Just couldn't get his feet down on that catch.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver, running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
Been a couple of times, though, when it looked like it might be, you know, curtains for Marvin in Cincinnati, and all he does is somehow find a way to rebuild the team. Two straight playoff seasons for the Bengals.
I think there's a couple times that Marvin Lewis was hoping that he would be done, because it was just almost a situation where you couldn't do what you wanted to do as a coach. Well, like we talked about, they switched that around, and now it's a pleasure to be a head coach of the Cincinnati Bengals.
Andy Dalton will be under center. First and 10. They're setting up screen. He stacked up at that point.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up. And when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Gresham's usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time.
Trouble now.
He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Third down here. Offense trying to pick up the first.
Dalton's turning to look downfield now after selling the play fake. Fights off the hit. Tackled at the 13.
When you see zone defenses, throw it into the open spaces. That's what the quarterback did that time. Good job by the receiver running in there and making the catch.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Now first and 10. A tackle behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Gresham's a tight end, but now shifted. Ball is out, and the defense has it. Bringing the play to an end.
That was just a terrible job by the offensive player that time. Protect the football. No excuse for letting it fumbling the football in a situation like that.
The 49ers will go with the pistol on this play. And 10. James going to secure the handoff. And he spins away.
When you run off tackle, one of the things you're looking for is for your tackle to make a good block. And then if you have a lead fullback, can he get past him and block the linebacker to free up the halfback so he can go in between them and get in the second?
And intercepted. That'll stop the play right there.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
Two tight ends, first and 10. He's scrambling now, looking for an open receiver on the right. Come out in the dime package. Second down and 10. the Bengals get a first down.
Jim, they call that a post route. Do you know why? Of course you don't know why. The wide receiver is running towards the goal post, so they call it a post route.
They've got a first down now after that catch.
On the run. Throws to the right. Incomplete.
Second down here.
They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, the quarterback's got to see this blitz when it's coming. And if he checks to an audible to get rid of the football quicker or give himself extra protection, that will help him a lot.
And we've reached the two-minute warning in this one. Jones is going to get set in the slot for this snap. Looking across the middle, and that pass is picked by Carlos Rogers. Good piece of tackle.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football, the results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. First and 10. The throw to the left. The pass complete. And he's brought to the ground.
I know it looks easy, but it's not. But a nice throw on the slant route. Slant route means you're slanting towards the inside. Good throw and catch.
Now on first down, they'll go back to the air. Thrown incomplete.
I don't know what was more terrible. That was a terrible route, terrible throw by the quarterback. Oh, and what a shock. It's incomplete.
Flex round! Flex round! Flex round!
LaMichael James is in the backfield. It's handed to the running back. Brought down at the 41-yard line.
Flex round! Flex round!
Third down, Ohio, following Ohio, the run.
Ohio.
They motion the receiver around to the other side.
Kaepernick from the gun. Antoine Bolden with the catch.
Another first down by the offense. The defense is definitely getting fatigued. And when you get fatigued, you cannot think, so look out.
The 49ers use another timeout here, and they have one left.
Ohio! Ohio!
First down here after the completion.
Looking to go up top again on first down. He has the grab. Good for 21 yards.
Well, they call this route a lot of things. They call it a bull route, a nine route, or a fly route. And all of them mean the same thing. Run as fast as you can, get behind the defense.
Staying with the passing game on first down.
When a quarterback can run, it usually takes one guy out of pass coverage. Look at the spy that time on the quarterback. That opens up the passing lanes. Good throw and catch.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Quarterback was under a lot of duress on that pass, and alas, it's incomplete.
Listen, I know he was under duress, but you got to hit these type of throws in the NFL. You're not always going to get perfect protection. That's not a good job by the quarterback.
Second and goal from the 10. They give it to him on the counter. Touchdown!
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
The Bengals are ready to return the kick. He will run this one back. Tackle down at the 42-yard line.
Down all the way.
Looking long. Almost intercepted.
Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Second down, 10. Dalton looking long. And they can't connect. Defense comes out of the dime. Third and 10. Forces a three and out. That does it here for the first half. Bengals trail in this one. We're back here now in this one where the 49ers are leading by 7. And he'll start his return. They spot it at the 42. First down as they head to the line. Going off tackle here. Searching for space to the right. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
The Bengals come out in the pistol. Leaning on that running attack again here on first down.
Good job by the defensive player squaring up that running back and just putting his big butt right into the ground.
Lined up in the pistol formation. Second down, 3 for the first. They feed him the ball again.
Gains 9.
Well, it's, you know, you're just getting dominated physically when the offense just runs the football right up the middle. The middle linebacker and the defensive tackles just have to be better.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. First and 10. Back to the ground, middle. And it's Patrick Willis who makes the tackle.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
Green Ellis is lined up in a single back formation. Looking to the right side and throwing. Incomplete.
Jim, that was really a terrific job by the quarterback. The pocket is breaking down. And look at that. He just steps up, moves out. Good job of keeping the play alive.
Green's lined up now as a slot receiver. Got a completion this time.
I thought that was a pretty risky play that time by the offense. Even though it's the second half and you're down, you don't always have to go for it on fourth down. Fortunate for them, they got it that time.
Ohio! Ohio!
Offense lines up here. No margin for error from just outside the goal line. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Now the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
No loading up with extra defensive backs in the dime. Runs it across for the score. Touchdown.
In today's game, you know, Jim, you always have to be alert in situations when the quarterback drops back to pass. You've got to think he might be able to run out of the pocket. And that time, the defense not alert for it. Nobody's there, and he scrambles in for a touchdown.
Waves his arm, and he's going to make a fair catch. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. They go counter. Breaks free. And he's out of bounds.
You know, when the linebackers, when they see that the offensive formation is shifted to one side, well, as a linebacker, you've got to play to that strong side and try to get up there and stop the run.
LaMichael James is in the backfield. And James has got it on the handoff. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
It's a mindset. It's a culture. That's what you've got to create when you talk about running the football. And when you get it going the right way, you can grind a defense up. Another first down for this offense running the football.
Staying with the running game on first down. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Here comes the wide receiver in motion. Second and one, and the give to Frank Gore, left side. Into the open now as he crosses the first down marker. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Running backs who can pick up extra yards, they are so valuable. You can't always block everybody to the ground. The running back's got to do it himself sometimes. Nice job there by the running back.
First down and 10. Frank Gore gets it here. The tackle was made.
Teams in the NFL spend about 30-40% of their time all week long practicing plays in the red zone. So there's a lot they can do here. Let's see if they come up with something that works.
First and goal. On first down, it's back to the ground game. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Second and goal. Runs it across. Touchdown.
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead.
Makes the PAT. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. He's got a chance to return this one. He's brought to a halt. Andy Dalton will be under center. First and 10. That catch, good for a first down.
Jim Nance, that was the old fly route. When we were kids, that's what they called it. See if you can fly by the defensive back. He did that time. Nice throw and catch.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Gets away from the pressure. Justin Smith brings the quarterback down.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see, when they don't have to blitz and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
Jones is in the slot. Goes deep to A.J. Green. That ball was going the other way. In on the stop.
Well, I have to say, that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. The wide receiver in motion. First and 10. Gore
wide to the left. Passes. He's in the clear. He's at the 50.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
15 minutes to go. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Flex round! Flex round!
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. The wide receiver shifting around in motion. The final quarter begins with this snap.
Scrambling out of the pocket, trying to work that left side. Pushes aside one tackler. They bring him to the turf.
The best way to keep the other offense on the sidelines is just keep marching down the field and picking up those first downs. What a good job by the offense.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. The quarterback motions the wide receiver.
Gore's handed the football, trying the right side.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
The 49ers line up in the pistol offense.
It's a second and five here.
And the give to Frank Gore.
I think you got to be a little more creative in the red zone than this. When you just line up and run the football like that, you're not going to get a lot of yards. And that time, they just got a short gain. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. Trying to beat the play clock.
They motion the receiver around to the other side.
Running a little college-like option. End zone bound, and he's got the touchdown.
When you got a lead, you march down the field, and you add on that lead with a touchdown, it's fun to watch the other team. Will they stay patient, or will they panic? My bet is they'll panic.
Extra point is good. The Bengals are ready to return the kick. Head on, right there at the 20. On first down.
Andy Dalton down the field, but it falls incomplete.
He's such a smart linebacker. That's one of the reasons why he was able to knock that pass down that time. He diagnosed the play. He saw what it was going to be, got himself in position, and he made it happen.
Gresham's playing out of position in the backfield here. Good fake. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you got that defense guessing.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
Dalton's play action on his way. The 40 runs out of bounds.
The quarterback that time realized it was zone coverage. He just waited for the defense to get out of position, and he threw it to the open hole.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
Dalton will take it from the gun. Goes deep to A.J. Green. And no one is going to catch this one as it goes out of bounds.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down.
It was right there, but he didn't bring it in.
Well, he dropped the football, and there's no doubt why he dropped it. You have to look it in.
Play number six coming up on this drive.
Third and ten.
It's incomplete. The defender had it for a moment, but could not pick it off cleanly. Gresham's a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play.
Dalton looking long.
Incomplete.
Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Gore's in the backfield. Single back set.
First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left.
He's wide open for the grab.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
The 49ers in the pistol. First and 10. Frank Gore gets it here. He'll go to the left. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
This play set up by the long gainer.
And they go back to the ground. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Bengals team official. The staff wasn't saying much about the injury other than it's not severe enough to keep him out of this one. So expect to see him back on the field shortly, guys.
Second and goal from the 2-yard line.
Gore shrugs off the first hit, and he's in for the touchdown.
Well, you got a lead, you drive down the field, you score a touchdown. Now we're going to find out if the other team can stay patient or will they panic.
And the point after is good. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. Ran the tape with a chance to run back this kickoff. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Andy Dalton will be under center.
Stands in the pocket.
And that pass is picked by Carlos Rogers. They got him down there.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just ran the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The 49ers will approach this play from out of the pistol. First and 10. Looking to go deep. But it's incomplete.
What a good job by the defensive back that time. That ball was thrown beautifully down the field. High arcing throw, but the defensive back in great position knocks it down.
That's second down coming up. Second and 10.
Quarterback flips it to the running back. Spins away from contact. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. Here's the first snap after the big play.
Running right through the trenches.
And he's going to pitch it here.
That was a running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
Second and 3. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Almost intercepted that time. Frank Gore is in the backfield. Third down and 3. Good, solid tackle. Short of the first. As now we've got a fourth down situation. Quarters formation here for the defense. Throws to the right. The 49. Ball is out. The defense has the football. Tackles made. The defense comes up with the big play, the hit, and the recovery of the football.
They sure did. They got so much speed on the defensive side, and that speed, when you think about it, it gets more people around the football. It helps you deliver the hit even harder, and that's why they got the turnover. Great job.
Andy Dalton down the field. Makes the catch deep down the middle of the field.
It's just not done enough, I think, in the league anymore. Everybody's so careful. But look what can happen. You can have the perfect throw, the perfect catch, and a big play.
That reception gave them the first down.
Goes deep to A.J. Green, and it falls incomplete.
Well, you must, on the offensive side, throw the football deep 3 or 4 times a game. That time, they're just not able to connect on the deep throw.
This will be second down.
Andy Dalton in the shotgun formation.
Got to make that play.
It's really simple. Keep your eyes on the football. When they're not on it, that's when you drop it, and that's what happened that time.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Alden Smith with the quarterback takedown.
Nice job that time of the outside linebacker getting the sack. They ask a lot of these guys now. They are special players in the NFL. Stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback too.
Looking to the right side and throwing. That's an interception. Ball comes out. Oh, they cough up the football. Defense takes possession.
Well, the defense always says, let's call some fumbles. Then when you cause it and you're not able to recover it, that is one emotional letdown.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. First and 10, challenging the defenders to the right side. Could have been intercepted.
Just stick the football on him. When you see a receiver run a route like this, they're going to the corner, drive it, throw it on a line drive. So that way, there can't be a mistake.
Three,
failing to complete that one. So second down here.
Quarterback tosses it to the outside. Oh, that could have been intercepted, but he couldn't hold on.
Well, the quarterback can't get him open. He threw to the right guy that time, but the coverage was so good by the defense, nowhere to get the completion.
Punters all set here.
Oh, it's a fake.
Going across the middle.
The pass falls incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series. Gore's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback.
Anquan Boldin with the catch.
Nice job by the coach that time going forward on fourth down. His team is up here in the second half. He wants to keep momentum on his side. That's why he goes forward.